Okay, Sarah, I'm so glad you asked me this question. You asked me, why does God allow people to be depressed? And so to share with you my answer, I'm going to draw a picture for you. Hopefully that'll be helpful. So first, let's just acknowledge the reality that we live in a world that is broken, right? I mean, you don't have to really understand too much to know we live in a broken world. You can watch the news. You can see the fighting and the war. You can look at your family and friends and see the sickness and disease. You can see the conflict and fighting to know that we live in a broken world. And something's not right about the world, right? This is not how it's supposed to be. And in fact, it's not. God created a world that was perfect. This was God's plan originally, that he wanted to create a perfect world for his people to dwell in, where he would live with his people and they would be his people, or they would be his people, he would be their God. And this is the plan that God had, but he put them in this perfect place and people decided to rebel. They only had one rule. And the first people, you can read it in Genesis chapter 3, they broke that one rule. They decided to go against God's plan. And so that's how we got from this perfect world to this broken world. Now, it's something we call sin, right? And so I know you're familiar with this. This term sin is anytime we go against God's will. So God's will was, you people live in this perfect place and I will live with you and we'll dwell here forever and there won't be any sickness and there won't be any disease. But when they decided to rebel against God, God had to introduce consequences into the world. He realized that people would much rather have their own way than his way. But if they're going to have their way, there has to be consequences for that. And so things started to enter the world through sin, things like disease, sickness, war, fighting, conflict. Those were never part of God's plan. Anxiety and depression, never part of God's plan. They entered the world through our original sin. Now what happens, because we don't like living in a broken world, we have this desire to get back to this perfection. What happens is we try to escape this brokenness, and some of us do it through like alcohol or drugs. We try to escape that. Some of us do it through chasing success or money, right? Or we think, well, if I could just make more money, if I could just have more things, I could not feel this brokenness. And some of us do it by pursuing relationships, boyfriends or girlfriends or husbands or wives, and we think, well, that will make us feel better about our lives. But the problem is, none of that is what caused us to be in a broken world. What caused it is sin. And so we couldn't possibly get our way back to God's plan because it wasn't our plan to begin with, it was God's. So God had to come up with a plan to help us escape this brokenness in a way that allows us to get back to perfection. And so his plan was to still allow us to have free choice, to still allow us to choose to do things, which means that we're going to have things like disease, and depression can be a disease. Depression can be caused by chemicals, chemical imbalance in your brain. But it can also be a result of our choices. Like this stuff that we're pursuing doesn't solve our brokenness problem. And so we get sad about it, we get depressed about it, we get anxious about it. And so God's plan was to send his son. You know, you can send somebody a letter or a postcard if you want to communicate. You can send a text or you can make a phone call. But if you really want to solve a problem, you send a person, right? And so God sent a person named Jesus, his one and only son. And Jesus came from heaven to earth. He lived a perfect life, and then he died a terrible death on a cross. But then 3 days later, he was raised from the dead. And this is to show us that he can overcome any of this stuff in our life, any of the anxiety, depression that we feel, any of these things that come from us trying to escape this broken world. God can overcome it because he raised Jesus from the dead. And so what he does is he gives us, this is God's way of getting us back to perfection, he gives us the opportunity to turn from our sin, to turn from all these things, and to trust Jesus. And when we trust Jesus, the promise he makes us is that we can start to follow him, and where he's going to lead us is back to this perfect world. That someday, if we follow Jesus, the promise is that someday we'll be back to perfection. That we'll be in this place where there is no more crying and no more sadness and no more tears and no more anxiety and no more depression. So this is how the problem got caused. And this was God's solution to it. I hope that helps you, Sarah. Feel free to ask me anything else you might have.